Hello World, today we play a NASA Standalone Szenario in Command Modern Operations. First Contact 1957, as the Norwegian Navy against Soviet attackers. Most of the enemy forces are motorboats on both sides. And some frigates by the Soviet side, and some good old-fashioned destroyers out of the Second World War on the Norwegian side. So we will see how this plays out. And nothing special features and realism options are on. So okay, let's begin the scenario. Okay, we are already have our radars on. Yeah, someone else we don't have. First, we disband this destroyer group and assign units. Mission. So, detach. So, because I will organize some. The destroyer we have in one group with two motorboats and another frigate with two motorboats. I will go, will be more closer how I want to organize them because how they are weaponized and which weapons they have and so on. So let us begin. Full speed. This motorboat group go flank. Destroyer goes flank. And this motorboat group goes through the channel at the fjord. Ay. Who is this so? Is that small? Ay. Didn't remember that it would be so small with flank speed. So let it run a little bit. We have old motorboats out of the Second World War. This will be the P-348 Stack and P-346Yo. Have you did oh scheiße. Okay, behind us. That's unusual. That's very unusual. Okay, it's friendly. Okay, it's a fishing vessel. Okay. Yeah, okay. Oh, it has radar. Okay. This petite boat. Yep, that's enemy. So, back to the MGB Fairmile D motorboat. It's practically, I guess, a motorboat out of 1945 to 1959 was used, so it was a late World War II motorboat. We see this by the heavy armament it has with the 45 inch, so 105 millimeter howitzer or cannon, something like this. So single Bofors and the 20 mm Oerlikon. Okay, so the torpedoes of this time are straight runners, so not much to do. How fast they are? 27 knots, that's not fast. Maybe I will detach you two and let you move individually through this tiny channel. The other side, go to flank speed, U2, sensors on, sonar you do not have. So, and because mo I guess most of the enemy vessels will do not have yeah, we are not in this day and time. So, we know that one of our Olimar motor torpedo boats are 27 max speed, and the Arendal destroyer is 25 knots max speed, so flank. They will merge into one group, and they will be very effective combat group against enemy motor boats. So, what does the Arendal has as weaponry? It has a submarine mortar, which does not matter because our sonar is very tiny, and I don't think the enemy has submarines in the area. I hope so. It has twin Bofors and single Bofors, and the good old 102 mm cannon. Oh, two of them. Two cannons with a high capacity. 6 nautical miles range. That should be enough against the enemy torpedo boats in range. So, but no reload. Okay. Early 1950s technology, late 1960s radar, surface search, and navigation sets. Pretty good. Okay, we have seen another skunk. Okay, so it seems that the enemy torpedo boats do not have detected our torpedo boats because it's sailing in an, towards the north, and we are evading towards the south. Then we have the Stavanger destroyer, our strongest ship here, with 3 114 millimeters and 10 nautical miles. They can even outrange the Riga class frigates of the Soviets, so they will be used against this alone, so the enemy can't fire at us. With 36 knots max speed, it has the same speed as our modern torpedo boats with 36 knots. Radar, okay, it has a little bit better sonar, at least passive sonar. So I hope there are no enemy submarines in our area. Then we have the frigate Draught, which is very slow with only 80, 21 knots max. It will be fighting together with two other torpedo boats as reserve group. It has very light weaponry with only 102 millimeter main gun, but it has Elint, and the others do not have it. That's very good. Early 70s technology, even, so a little bit far behind our schedule here. Behind before. So, more or less. So, in the end, this will be a very valuable asset to detect enemies who are not in our radar range. There are no enemy air target, air threats. So the most important part are the yellow and the red circles. Then the other torpedo boats, the more modern torpedo boats we have from the Rapp class of 1953, who are early, have early 70s radar and only 20 mm Oerlikon cannons and 40 mm cannons, both of us with 3 nautical miles range. So they are our last asset to use and only to protect our bigger ships against incoming torpedo boats. Okay, hope they escape and go for the run. The fishing vessel can be there, it does not matter. You see the marked the crosses there, the four. That's practically the engagement zone we guess the Soviets are in. Here they are following us with 45 nautical miles. This means they are. Yes, they are definitely enemy torpedo boats. Not identified yet. So let us continue. Okay. Maybe say crash into the land. Yeah, it seems. Okay, so I can't follow us here. Because they crash into the land. Okay. We will deal with you later. Faster. Speed things up. So you are here. You are also a destroyer. You are against the enemy. High capable ships. Mm-hmm. Ah, this will be a formation massacre. Okay. You can stay more or less so. S1 formation. You stay there. You can stay there. So, should be it. You are moving here, and they are moving there, so you can move a little bit more down. Okay. I mark them. Mark the three Stavanger and the two torpedo boats. And unit orders, group select units. So, I don't know. So, how does this where I did it before? Undersign is for set. So if I detach you, and if I detach you, then the formation get disbanded, right? Yeah, okay. So, I don't know, stop. So, and into one group again. Okay. So come on. I did this many times before. Sometimes it won't even will not do it. Okay, you have to be in the unit and not the group. Okay. Switched to the unit view, not to the group view. It's the key F. No. Okay, that's a ridiculous game. You know, it's really ridiculous. That's a moment. You are ridiculous. Yeah. Give me them in one group. You did it before. Thank you. Now we have it. And let them drive a little bit closer to the enemy on creep. The others detach from group and detach. Stop, and you are stopped anyway. Move a little bit back. So we have a good old formation. Doing it. So where do the ships want to go? Yep, on this side, okay, so that's a little bit weird what you want to do, but you can do it. Good. Marking and yep, now you are one group. You go to the outer edges with flank speed. You can creep frontally into the enemy. What's happening with you guys? No and no. Okay, a little bit derpy sometimes, but okay, everything is online by you. Very good. Okay, and so they are matching up. And okay. So hopefully we can do as I planned. If not, then we will have a little bit of a problem. No detection of other vessels. Good. In a nice formation, may formation, and then group, wonderful. So this group goes full throttle in. We will see how this works. Will work out. Okay, they are yep at the station point. No flank, please. Oh, we have spotted. Skunk service 5 nautical miles, radar navigation. I guess it will be another fishing ship. So you going to creep? Yes, you are going in with flank and forward time. Fast as possible. Okay, we have detected this fishing ship again. There's a skunk, it's on 5 nautical miles. Yeah, 5 nautical miles seems a commercial speed. A bit late on to the outer edges with this third surface group, the draught group. So cruiser group go, the destroyer group go a little bit more into the center, and the frigate group, what is it? No, it's another destroyer group, the Aurelion, how it's called. So, Arendal group goes more towards the south, where we have seen enemy motorboats. Can the main group can go up to or increase its speed to cruise. The others from flank to cruise back. We don't need to outpass the southern group. How fast it is? 20 nautical miles. It can be. Can be another major service vessel. Is the Riga class? Possibly so. Not sure. We will see. It's a frigate, so okay, okay. Back off my little destroyer group, and the main destroyer will handle Sam. So. Okay, that was another Riga class, maybe. Okay, we will see how it goes. Okay, they are. Oh, we have to go up. You have to move to the north with the Arendal and go to creep with Stavanger. And oh, they are coming. Destroy the Riga class with your main batteries. You have near 1,000 rounds. Put 300 rounds of your nice ammunition into this target. Oh, 100 is the max allocation. Okay. So, what it is? It is the SKR Riga Goronasti. Was used until the end of the Soviet Union. Okay, it's a normal frigate. It has late 60s, surface search, air and surface search. Okay, weapon director. It is Elend. Oh, very good. Hull sonar. Hmm. Okay, it has a range of 6 nautical miles, not 12. So, yep, like I told you, we can outrange them. Yeah, if it come in close, it will be a problem. So. They are reforming the groups. This will take a lot of time. Say in range. Yes, we start firing. It's our weaponry. Start fire. Okay, got a hit. Events fired. Type it into. Oh, yep, they are the patrol boats and they are heading in. Okay, many misses and some hits. How can we do it a little bit? Yeah, a little bit more silent. Yeah. Okay, at least they are lightly damaged. That's good. But does have we come show me the weaponry? Do we have as a reloading? Okay, this takes a time. 1 minute and 20 seconds to reload. Flank speed. Yeah. Okay, what's that? TKP-6 torpedo boats. Out of 1949, used until the end of the Soviet Union. It seems like the Soviet Union uses every asset it has until the end of time. So, at least it had radar. It has radar. The 20mm cannons, the two it has twin linked, is not of a threat, really. Maybe for our most modern torpedo boats because they do not have the range. Yeah, but Two torpedo mounts are not an issue there. So 4 nautical miles must be so close. Hopefully we can circumvent them. or circumvent it. 100 rounds into this ship. You, most forward ship. This deck put some rounds, 25 of them, into it. And the rear, the yo into the other one behind of some 25 in. Okay, the draw, maybe intercept from behind, flank speed. Yes, I think we need every asset we can have. Okay, move them away, the Savager group, or group 47 on cruise. Oh, on flank. We need more time before we can really. I hope it's blue dying. Okay, because I allocated already. Can I unallocate? Because if I do unallocate all of them, then maybe it will follow. That's a little bit of a mess I have here. Ah, so many torpedo boats approaching us. That will be heavy. Aye, aye, aye. Go at, go. Go away. What's a thousand? It's all the speed you have. Hopefully something got destroyed by the Riga class. So we can hammer them a little bit down. Or at least they do not effectively counter fire. It gets so loud. The impacts are heavy. If this game would have the Bismarck or the Yamato, I guess I would go deaf. fire? Oh, come on. Yes, the Arendal opens fire. Sensors are running on full steam. Good, good. So hopefully we will sink this torpedo boat. Misses. Massive misses. Some impacts, okay. A lot of misses, yeah. What's expected here? What are the regular? Okay, at least we have regular guys and not cadets. Very good. Good, good. Okay, say okay, because this has to catch up. Go flank speed. Okay, it. Something is destroyed, or is that at least light damaged? Very good. S So, you can fire 25 of your short HE shots into this target. How many of your shots have you left? By the motorboat, 38, okay. I guess it's flooding, it slows down, so it should be damaged enough. Reloading. Ah, okay. It opens fire again, so I hope. It has major flooding and light damage, so. And it slows down. Yeah. And our ships are very problematic here. Yeah. So Arendar is reloading, I guess. Yeah, okay. Keep firing. If we can keep them at bay, it would be okay. It would be very good. Four nautical miles, yes, but this does not matter because they are not a major ship. Damage, contact, sighted, misses, massive, a lot missed here. Yeah, I mean it's practically Second World War naval combat. So. It's more questionable that you hit than you practically in these modern days do. Okay, a stream of shots coming in. A little bit more back. Okay, now they have medium damage and flooding as they are slowing down. Okay, they are practically out of the game. Good. I guess engine damaged with the severe flooding by the first Riga class frigate. Come on guys, let it happen. Destroys the torpedo boat, please. They could, but okay, destroyed. Then you are engaging, the Arendal engaging the other boat with 100 rounds, or with 200 rounds. Should be fine. The rear Yo boat named Yo is firing his ammunition, his HE, 105mm ammunition. It has fire, the forward boat stack has fired half of the ammunition. So they have a little bit left. Okay. Can open fire with all left to the assessor, PT boat number 10. So, I shouldn't go flank speed, go cruise speed, and the others go flank. Yeah, you can go down to cruise again. You have enough cover now. The others heading in with flank speed. As fast as they can. Okay. Weapons are reloading here. Speed things up a little bit. Okay, that was a good hit. Hit. Many shots missed. You can fire to petit boat number 11 with all 25 left. Bofors have a range of 3 nautical miles. Are they in? Yes, they are in. Engage them with your Bowforce 2. You. They are nearly in. You engage them with your Bowforce 2. They could have launched their torpedoes. Oh, that will be horrifying if they did this. You have Bowforce 2, I guess they have the same range. Yes, they have. Okay, engage them with 100 shots of your Bowforce. It comes down to the wire. It comes down to the wire, I guess. So do not. You can fire the last 25 shots into it, and then fires 100 shots into the other approaching frigate. Sister Venture will do the job, I guess. The draught is too slow. So approaching full speed, faster, lads. Heavy damage. Put in 100 of your Bowforce rounds to Sam. Do it. So it's allocated anyway. There is something allocated. Yes, Bowforce are definitely better suited for this kind of war because of the high amount of fire. Ay ay ay. It's getting louder, yeah. Okay, one destroyed. So we can head there again. More towards the west. You have some HE left. You can shoot all your HEs there. No Bowforce left? Okay. Only say orderly cons, and they have only a range of 1 nautical miles. So the enemy 20mm guns will practically outrange us here. Your Bowforce was allocated. Yes, you have 100 of this Bowforce allocated to SEM 2. Okay, it's out of ammunition. You are reloading. Okay, you are well, combat ready, get fast, go to creep to have a high accuracy, I hope. Okay, the other torpedo boat is heavy damaged too. Yes, that could help. Oh, it's coming too close, really too close for me. Go to flank and a little bit away. Oh, you can go closer. Go to, yeah, the fourth group, go to flank. It has ammunition left. Have you assigned it? No, but we could spare it. Yeah, 100 more allocated of the twin bitch burst. Guess your weapon has to reload. Yes, you are. As long as there are no torpedoes in the water, we have a good chance. There should be two other torpedo boats around there by Hammerfest. Oh, it's so far north. What's up with this Riga? No damage. Heavy damaged fire and flood with the, and heavy flooding with the other. Okay. Reloading, okay. It's dead in the water, the TKP6 boat there. Torpedo boat there with heavy fire, or major fire, major flooding, and heavy damage. So, sensor block will go on and see what's going on there by near Hammerfest if there are the two left. Okay. I guess most of the ship is practically destroyed of the weaponry and the engine, so we could get closer. Not so sure if I wanted to. Okay, the other ship is okay. Engines destroyed too. By the other Riga frigates, so they are dead in the water. Here we creep. How many shots do we have? I allocated 200 left, and the other has 24 left. We have destroyed the torpedo boat in the north, that's good. No torpedo hit us, so we can go around and they can investigate into Hammerfest or near the area around Hammerfest, and the surface group 3, I could say. Ah, the reserve is a draught in the center. The ships have a 19 hours fuel left. The tiny boats, motorboats, the newer ones, it only 1 hour to go left. So, hopefully, we will destroy the Riga classes. Okay. 100 allocated to Sam and the other get 100 allocated to then again 100 allocated and the other has 69 left to allocate. So yeah. Yeah, maybe with the drought I have to go in and destroy the ship because its weaponry is at the front, I guess. They don't shoot at us now and have heavy damage, so I guess they are pretty out of commission. Go directly towards Hammerfest now is the Arendal group. Ah, sound of guns in the morning. Ah, very, very good. Very good. Okay, one sunk. Allocate everything you have left. Yep. To the Asariga class. Sunk two. Oh, that's very good that we have even ammunition left after this engagement. Not thought about this. Okay, then go in and investigate the other torpedo ships. Go, go, go. Where? Where? What's that? How fast? 5, okay. You could investigate it, but it's likely to be commercial shipping. Yeah, we send the drop group, it should deal with it. If it's an enemy vessel. Okay. You are sailing a little bit more to the north. Yep. You can sail a little bit more to the west and you go in. The Arendal group, are they there or not? Where's this, all the ships they had? Okay, scenario has been concluded. Okay, it's a minor victory. Okay. I guess I haven't seen the two ships they have left. Because it's a minor victory here. Lost a lot of ammunition. Killed two Riga classes and 40Ks. P6 patrol boats. Oh, they shot one torpedo at us, but it failed. Okay, to connect. Okay, well, I missed outright. But that's only a minor victory. You can have at max 1000 points, so. Yeah. Okay. I have missed these two ships somehow. Must be there near Hammerfest. And I run out of time. Okay, so that's it with the scenario from the Norwegian side. I will play the scenario from the Soviet side later. Have a nice day. Servus, and with many Stukas, Kamerad.